In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make simple animation in Drama. To add an animation to your scene, simply click on this Edit Animation button here at the bottom. And here's the timeline, which shows everything that happens during your animation. The timeline is currently empty because our scene has no animation. So let me show you how to add an animation. This playhead shows the currently displayed time. You can grab it and move around like this to change the current time. To add an animation, simply change something either in your workspace or in the inspector. So I'll change the height of this layer here. Like this. And you can see that something has already appeared. You can read it like this. This is a layer called button, with an attribute called height that goes from 50 to 104 in about a second. And these things at the sides are keyframes. You can edit keyframe values by double-clicking them and changing their value like this. Okay, and you can already play the animation and see that the height changes. Let's add more animations here. So at about this time, I want the layer width to be 110. And you can see another attribute has been added here. I can do the same thing by adding corner radius 55 here. Let's play this. I also want this download text to disappear during this animation, so I'll simply change its opacity to 0. You can see that the animation of opacity from 100% to 0% has been added. I can also move the keyframes around to make this happen faster. Now the text will disappear first, and then the blue layer will morph. You can move these boxes around and collapse and expand as wanted. By the way, the entire timeline can be scrolled either by your touchpad or shift scrolling with your mouse. It can also be zoomed with your touchpad or by command scrolling with your mouse. We also have the handy Option Command Zero shortcut, which fits the entire animation to your screen like this. Let's make this animation a bit more interesting. I'll select these areas between the keyframes and change the timing function, which is displayed here, and shows how attribute values are animated. And right now we're using the ease in, ease out timing function. We can change this, for example, to linear or spring, and I can make it bouncier like so. When I play this now, you can see a nice animated wobbly effect. Now, let's zoom this out and move to the next part of the animation. But first, let's talk about the recording mode. When you start editing your animation, the recording mode is automatically turned on, as indicated by this button being red and pulsating. Turn it off at any time, just like this. The playhead will change from red to gray, and the attributes' names change from red to gray, like this. And when recording mode is turned off, you can change anything in your workspace or in the inspector, and no new keyframes will be added. So when I click on the progress oval layer here now, I can change some attributes and no new keyframes will be added. Changing each oval's start angle and end angle attributes alters how much oval is displayed, and we'll use this to indicate progress. Let's activate the recording mode and move the playhead here. At this time, I want the end angle to be 0 degrees. And at this time, 360 degrees. We don't need the keyframe with the original value, so I'll select and click Delete to remove. Let's see what happens now. Next, I want to animate this text here. I'll move the playhead to the end and change the text to 100%, like so. Okay, and it animates from the very start, so the text is changing before progress is even displayed. That means the animation now takes much longer than this one, which we don't want. So I'll simply drag this keyframe here to ensure both animations take the same time. Let's improve this further. I don't want these layers to be visible at the animation start, so let's add a fade-out effect and changing opacity of progress text to 0. Then at this time, I want opacity of 100%. Here, I want 100% again, and I can insert a new keyframe by simply double-clicking. Then I'll drag the new keyframe to align with the playhead. Finally, at this time, I want opacity of 0%. And again, we don't need this keyframe, so I'll remove it. I'll repeat the same steps for the progress oval. So move playhead here. Change opacity to 0. Move playhead here. Change opacity to 100%. Insert new keyframe here. Insert new keyframe there. Change value to 0% and align with other keyframe. I'll also remove the keyframe that we don't need. Let's preview the animation. Okay. Now, moving on to the final part, this Bezier. But first, I need to turn the recording mode off again. So this is a simple tick mark drawn with a Bezier. I'll access the stroke setting here. Right now the stroke is solid line, but I'll change this to partial line and change the line end attribute here. With this attribute, you can control how much tick mark is drawn. We'll use this to animate the tick mark. So let's turn the recording mode back on. Move the playhead here, and at this time I want line end to be 0%, and at this time 100%. This keyframe I'll remove. And it's animated. Look closely and you'll notice that some Bezier is visible at the very beginning. That I don't want, so I'll set tick mark opacity to 0% somewhere here, so it's not visible at the beginning. And sometime later, I'll change to 100%. I'll also get rid of the initial keyframe. Next, let's customize this timing function to make it more lifelike by using the custom timing function. I'll drag these handles to make a timing function that sharply accelerates towards the end, which simulates the dynamics of drawing the tick mark by hand. Let's check it out. Great! Let's combine everything we've created so far into a single drawing. I'll turn the recording mode off again. Now I'll move these layers over the oval here like this. And move the Bezier here. Now a single animation shows what happens after I click the download button. First, the download button morphs. Then progress is made and finally the tick mark is drawn. To finish this animation, let's turn the recording mode on again. Now I'll select the button here. At the end of the animation, I want the button to be green and maybe a bit brighter, like this. And you can see that the fill color animation has been added from blue to green. But I only want this animation to happen at the end when the tick mark is drawn. So I'll drag this keyframe here and I can preview the whole animation again. Great. So that's how you make animations in Drama. Thanks for watching.